assembly was attempted, there was no statement from any quarters to also rectify this anomaly. But a time shall come that men shall rise. A time shall come that men will confront death. A time shall come that men and women will resist evil. And that time is now. The battle to rescue Kogi State from King Herod, aka Yaya Bello, is a battle of no retreat,
no surrender.
We are ready to spill our blood to rescue civil servants of Kogi State who are dying on daily basis because their salaries have been diverted by the government of King Herod. The time has come that men and women should come out of their cocoon and rescue Kogi State. We have never had it so bad. We have never had it so terrible in the history of Kogi State. When they have not even built any project, the projects they inherited, they are about to sell. But God forbid, we shall not allow Yaya Bello to sell our common patrimony and heritage. We shall not allow him to sell Conflict Beach. We shall not allow him to sell our liaison office in Abuja. We shall not allow him to sell the commissioner's quarters. We shall not allow him to sell the House of Assembly quarters. No project or heritage of Kogi State will be sold by Yaya Bello. We will die on this matter. We will fight and make sure that we tame this prodigal son who have come to take us back to the land of Egypt. We are also here to say that what is happening in Kogi State, where the herdsmen have been maiming and killing and taking away the resources of our citizens, is as a result of the open blanket check and invitation that Yaya Bello gave to herdsmen to come to Kogi State. The degree and magnitude of the ravaging effect of herdsmen in Kogi State was never like this before, until Yaya Bello declared that Kogi State is open, until Yaya Bello summoned all traditional rulers and gave them a marching order that there will be colony in Kogi State. But I declare in the name of the Lord, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, there shall be no colony. We will entertain no colony in Kogi State. And I want to say that it is shameful that after Kogi State government spent over $1 billion on screening exercise, the result at the end of the day is a beautiful nonsense. Now the whole exercise has been sidelined, has been thrown away, and salaries have not been paid. We are saying that every kobo stolen by Kogi State government and our champions, every kobo stolen by Edward Onoja, every kobo stolen by Yaya Bello, his wives and children, will be recovered to the last penny. Yes. We assure Kogi.